Hey guys, it's Sarah back with Glam Finds, and in honor of us, I think most of the world being stuck at home right now due to this whole COVID-19 thing, since I can't go anywhere, I'm probably going to do several videos a day, because what else am I going to do, right? And I actually wanted to bring this video to you because I thought I already posted one with this review, because I really like this fragrance, but I didn't. So it is Versace Pour Homme. The light blue juice, and I got this one recently because I got a really good deal on a tester. I got it for like $30 for 100 ml, and you know it's a tester because the side of it says tester, and I think it tells you everything that's in it, which it says that it's a aromatic fougere woody fragrance, which let's talk about it. So, I actually really, really enjoy this fragrance. It's really refreshing as the juice color might suggest. And it was an easy blind buy for me. I mean, I could have went and smelled it at any store by me because I'm near a pretty large mall. But I didn't really want to because it's Versace. And all of the Versaces that I've ever purchased have been incredible. They are super easy blind buys. But onto the fragrance itself, this one has a lot of citruses, which I really, really like, especially for spring and summer. So you're going to get your lemon, bergamot, and then you're going to get some floral notes, and I don't always love them, but there's just some neroli and rose in here, and it's actually pretty nice. And then in the base, you're going to get things like sage and cedar, which complement those top notes pretty well. And then you're going to get things like tonka bean, which I think you can smell. It's a pretty solid base note in here, and then you're gonna get musk, and I think it's ambergris. Hold on, let me double check it. Yeah, amber. Sorry, close. But all in all, it's a really well balanced fragrance. I think people say that it smells like Chanel Allure Homme Sport. I do not own that. And if it smells like that, I don't really have a reason to buy that because I don't feel like I need to make any redundant purchases. But that to the side, this is a really refreshing fragrance. And it's Versace, so it's a people-pleasing fragrance as well. I know, you know, a lot of people want like a really unique, different fragrance, but in my opinion, this is an awesome one because it's going to be a compliment getter. But not only are other people gonna like it, you're gonna like it because it's really refreshing, to my nose at least. And it has floral notes without being too heavy in them because, I don't know, I don't typically like that. But I like the fragrance. I think the fragrance itself is a very solid fragrance. In terms of people-pleasing, it is a people-pleasing fragrance. It is a compliment monster. This one is really easy to pull compliments with. And let's move on to performance so I can talk about how that relates to compliments. Longevity, you're gonna get, I would say between 6 and 7 hours. I don't think you're gonna get too much more. I don't need much more than that because I'm not trying to wear fragrance through like a 3-day marathon or anything. So I think it's fine. It's almost a full work day. And it gives you a pretty solid scent bubble. So the people that you walk by or walk past you are going to smell you because that's where I was getting most of my compliments when I wore it. And when I presently wear it because it is currently in my rotation. It's a real spring and summer beast. And I think technically today might be the first day of spring, but I've still been wearing it on days where it's warmer because I think it's really nice. If you've seen my first impressions video, I liked it right off the bat. I mean, it's a really good fragrance. And when you spray it, like, you don't need to bring it up to you. Your area kind of smells like it, which... So that's the sillage. You're going to get a pretty solid projection off of it for several hours. The sillage is really where I think it shines because I think most of my compliments were when people were, like, when I was walking past people or maybe someone was walking past me. And as you guys know, I usually do the 5 sprays. You don't need to reapply this, in my opinion. If you reapply it, it can be too much. Because initially, this is a very refreshing, citrusy fragrance. But if you apply too much, I think because in my opinion, I don't know if this is what it is, but I think because it has neroli and those floral notes, it can be a little bit cloying. My opinion, you might have a different opinion, but you're gonna get solid performance out of this. And I just think it's such an easy grab. So if you're not really sure what to wear, this is such an easy go-to. I mean, mostly anything Versace is a pretty easy go-to, but I really like this one. I don't know that I like it more than Dylan Blue. Dylan Blue is a little bit darker. And of course it's got the Ambroxan Balm in there, but as of right now, these two, this one and Versace Dylan Blue, are kind of head-to-head with me. I've gotten a ton of compliments with the other one, so, but to be fair, I've worn that one a lot more than I've worn this, so I'm gonna give this a lot more wearing, and maybe one day I'll just do them head-to-head and see which one is more of a compliment beast. I think this one's more of a daytime wear, and Versace Dylan Blue is more of a evening fragrance. But I think you can wear both of them any time of day anyways, so it doesn't matter. But anyways, that is my review on Versace Pour Homme. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.